surely going to improve the treatment outcome. So the types of Aushadha Sevanakala according to different acharyas. According to Charaka, Sushruta and Vakpada, it is 10. And according to Ashtanga Sangraha, it is 11. And according to Sharangadhara Samhita, it is 5. And the reference you can see in Sushruta Uttara Tantra, 64th chapter. And in Ashtanga Hridaya Sutra, 13th chapter. And also in Charaka Chikasa, 13th chapter. So these are the types according to different acharyas. And this Ashtanga Hridaya is not mentioned about Andarbhaktam. And also about Nishi, Sushruta and Charaka is not mentioned about Nishi. And this is according to various acharyas that we'll discuss one by one in detail. So the first one is Anannam or the Abhaktam. So before going to this, the Samhitas are written years back. So that time, the only two Aushadha Kalas were there in the previous time. So for the academic purpose or for the exam purpose, we can write all this. But when it comes into the practical aspects, it is little bit different. So now the Ahara Kalas are also different. Now it is three or four Kalas we are taking food. So keeping that in mind, the first one is Ananna or Abhakta. Abhakta means that is, it is administering medicine before taking any food on empty stomach. Or medicine becomes very powerful in the absence of food. And the absorption power will be more in the absence of food. So in the case of children and old age persons and women, so for all these persons, this time is not advisable because of the poor strength. And this is based on the this time of administration is based on the strength of the patient. If the patient is having strength only, this time is applicable. So mainly this Ananna Kala, it is given when the Kapha Dosha is vitiated predominantly. In such cases, we will give in this state. So there are many synonyms, Abhakta, Ananna, Nirbhukta, Suryodaya Chati are the synonyms. Suryodaya, it is given in Sharangadhara Samhita. And also in Sushruta Uttara Tantra also it is given Tatra Bhaktam Tu Yat Kevalam Aushadam Upayujyate. And in Darshana commentary that Abhaktam means it is Nirbhaktam. So without taking food. And again the Chakrapani he mentioned that it should be before food in the morning. And the food should be administered only after the medicine is completely digested. And also Hemadri, he commented like, it is the Kala he is mentioning here. Which Kala is? It is in the Kapha Udrega Gata Kala. And Kapha Kala, it is the one-third part of the day. And later half of this one-third is Kapha Udrega Gata Kala. And in this time, this medicine should be administered. And again, according to Indu commentary, it should be one yama after sunrise. The medicine is administered in the empty stomach because when the dosha is devoid of kapha utplesha, if there is kapha utplesha, then the medicine will not come in contact with the jadaragni and it will not be properly digested and the effect will be reduced and the effect of the medicine will be reduced. So this medicine is administered only after the kapha udrega is over. and the indications, the action enhanced due to empty stomach, the physician should see the strength of the patient. And if both are strong, this kala should be selected. And this can be used as lekanartha or especially in utkrishta kapha pitta state. And the contraindications, it is contraindicated in children as we already mentioned that it is based on the strength of the patient. If the strength is less, then this time of administration, it is not applicable. So like a children, aged patients, they can't withstand the potency of the medicine. So this kala is not applicable to these persons. And in this, the main aspect is the medicine should be taken without food. So as I mentioned in the earlier times, there were only two annakalas per there. Now it has changed. So the main thing we have to notice when into clinical aspects. So suppose if a patient takes heavy food in the night, like at around 10 o'clock or 12 o'clock, suppose if he had taken any biryani or anything. And in the morning, sometimes if it is kapha udreka gata kala also, sometimes that food will not get digested. So such cases, this is not applicable. So whatever food he consumed the previous day should be digested properly in the morning. So we have to advise the patient to take the food at the earliest, that means dinner, around 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock, then it will be digested. So the next day morning, he can take the medicines. So here the main point you have to notice that without food, this kala is indicated. And also after the complete digestion of this medicine, the food should be taken after the digestion of this food, after the digestion of the medicine. And the next kala, it is the pragbhakta or annada. Pragbhakta, it is administering medicine just before the meal. So it is consumed in this, then if it is just before the meals, then the action will be it becomes easily digested or quickly digested. And the medicine should be given before the food for like bala, vriddha, etc. Like patient who are fearful or emaciated, and also in women. That is Sushruta, he explained Vriddha, Shishu, Biru, Krishanga, and also so in all these cases we can give in Pragbhakta. And also in this one, the dosha, that is also, it is very much important. In this case, if the apana vata is aggravated or if it is vitiated, then this pragbhakta, in pragbhakta time, the medicine should be administered. And also pragbhakta, annado, divasa bhojana purvam, or sayam bhojana purvam, all these have the same meaning. And that will be digested quickly also. And it destroys the dosha situated in amashya. And especially here the dosha, which dosha is very much important. It should be given before food, that is in apana vayu vaikunya. And the third one is the madhyabhakta. Madhyabhakta means the administration of medicine in the middle of the meal. The medicine consumed in the middle of the meal, it cures the middle part of the body, that is by not spreading out of the middle part. And it is also madhyabhaktam, anna madhyam or bhojana madhyam, all these having the same meaning. So in this, it is the if the samana vayu is vitiated, then we can give the food in between food. So due to its not spreading, that avisari bhava, dakhana, he mentioned it as madhetu. Madhetu pidam idam abhaharante avisari bhavate. That is due to its quality of not spreading, avisari bhava, it subsides the disease of madhya sharira. That is, the medicine acts on samana vata. Once the samana vata is corrected, agni start functions properly. So if pachaka pitta is corrected, all the other pittas will function normally. So this is also indicated in paithaka vyadhi.